promised you a rose garden along with the sunshine. There's gotta be a little rain sometime.
Joe South's first appearance on the Billboard Pop Album chart came on February 8, 1969 with Introspect. Although it never was a huge seller, the project developed an impressive track record, yielding the hits Walk a Mile in My Shoes and Games People Play, the latter covered by Freddie Weller, reaching number 2 on the country chart. That album had made a big impression on Lynn Anderson, a 21-year-old vocalist under contract with Chart Records, a subsidiary of RCA. On May 4, 1969, Anderson married songwriter and record producer Glenn Sutton. By the following year, she had left Chart and signed with Columbia, going to number 3 with her debut single for the label, Stay There Till I Get There. She kept insisting that Sutton allow her to record a song from the Introspect album called Rose Garden, but he repeatedly nixed the idea because some of the tune's lyrics, Sutton felt, were not suited for a female artist. Especially problematical was the line, I could promise you things like big diamond rings, which was not something a woman would say to a man, so the song was deemed inappropriate for a female to sing. One evening at Nashville's Columbia Studios, Lynn's session ended 15 minutes earlier than scheduled, and they had nothing else planned, so Anderson again suggested Rose Garden to Glenn. This time, Sutton relented simply for the sake of filling up the time. Lynn had secretly been practicing Rose Garden all the while, just in case she ever got the chance to do it. She already had a makeshift arrangement worked out, but when there were problems with the first take, a few of the session players, particularly Charlie McCoy and Jerry Kennedy, who had taken a short time out from his production chores at Mercury, came up with a different pattern, later dubbed the Rose Garden Shuffle. It was a technique that had actually been started a few years earlier by Bill Anderson at Decca, then called the Blue Beat. Kennedy remembered cutting an instrumental called Blue Beat back around 62, which featured that beat. Then Owen Bradley picked up on it and cut several Bill Anderson records with that sound in the early 60s. Initially, Columbia's country division planned another song for Lynn Anderson's next release, but label president Clive Davis, in town for a convention, happened to hear Sutton mixing Rose Garden in Columbia Studio B. After a second listen, Davis pronounced that it would be Anderson's next single. While Rose Garden vaulted toward number 1 on Billboard's Hot Country Singles chart, it simultaneously went to number 3 on the Billboard Hot 100 Pop chart. The tune made its number 1 landing on the country playlist December 26, 1970, where it remained for 5 weeks. Both the single of Rose Garden and the album of the same name sold in excess of 1 million copies and won Lynn the 1970 Grammy for Best Country Vocal Performance by a Female. In 1989, the song made a unique appearance on the pop charts once again when excerpts from Anderson's vocal were lifted from Rose Garden and inserted into I Beg Your Pardon, a dance record by Con Can.
I beg your pardon.